Now, when we think about the word evangelist, we often think about someone like a Billy Graham or one of our favorite preachers who's packing out stadiums. Or maybe we have some negative thoughts about the guy on the street corners who's yelling at people. But the word evangelist simply means someone who's bringing good news. In fact, the word evangelist is used to describe a man in the New Testament by the name of Philip. Now, Philip was not one of the apostles. He was someone who was just serving and volunteering in his church. Now, as he's being faithful, we read in Acts chapter 8 that God intervenes and God sees Philip's faithfulness and he allows him to go and proclaim the gospel to someone of great influence. And this person was a leader in Ethiopia. It's the story of the Ethiopian eunuch, someone who worked for the queen. Now, by this providence of God, Philip hears this Ethiopian person reading from Isaiah chapter 53. Philip was ready because he was being faithful serving God, and he began with that very passage and began to articulate the truths about Jesus Christ. This man was converted and he believed in Jesus, and Philip baptized him. We later see that this man, Philip, has four daughters and they're unmarried. And the Bible says that they also prophesied, so that these women were single, they weren't married, and God is using them to do the work of an evangelist. So an evangelist is not someone who necessarily has to work full-time in church. The person could be married or they could be single. They could be male or they could be female. God can use you. There's been seasons in my life in which I worked full-time in ministry, but right now I've been working in medical sales. I interact with doctors, with nurses, medical assistants, receptionists, patients who may not step foot in my church. And I have an opportunity to see them, to listen to them, and sometimes proclaim the good news of Jesus Christ. God has allowed these opportunities, even while I'm presenting to these patients at lunch. It's not all the time, but sometimes a conversation will come up in which a doctor or a nurse will ask a question, and I can explain to them my story, what God has done in my life. What about with you? What is your circumstance? Where has God placed you? You may think to yourself, I don't like my current job, but God can use your faithfulness in your current job to reach people who do not believe the hope of Jesus Christ. You can be an everyday evangelist, just like Philip, just like his daughters. God can use you.